At Advanced Arm Dynamics, one of our goals is to always provide the most up-to-date technology for our patients. Part of that commitment is really looking at electric hands. And so over the last 20 years, we've really been involved with development on hands. So we really work with manufacturers all over the world and create a partnering type of atmosphere where we're involved early on with the development of technology. And this partnering allows us to bring this technology very early to our patients. And our patients play a really critical role in the development so that the final product is as optimized as possible. We've developed a strong relationship with Ottobock, located in Vienna, Austria. We've been traveling to Vienna for the last 15 years, working with their engineers to help develop new components. And what we really do is we provide the clinical experience to work with their engineers to help improve products. Over the last 3.5 years, we've had the opportunity to work on the Michelangelo project. This is an incredible hand that's going to provide so much function for patients. We had the opportunity to bring our first team over to Vienna with a patient and an occupational therapist and really work with Ottobock to try to optimize the function of the hand. At Advanced Arm Dynamics, we have the opportunity to work with a lot of new technologies, but I got to say, we're really excited by the Michelangelo hand. I'd like to introduce you to our patient, Ethan. Ethan's had the opportunity to be working on the Michelangelo project for the last 3.5 years. And I'd really like Ethan to talk to us a little bit about what the Michelangelo hand means to him. So Ethan, can you tell me a little bit about what's different about this hand?
The products that I've used in the past basically had one grasp pattern. And that's the three-point pinch.
So it's this, okay.
What I really enjoy about the Michelangelo, however, is that it can transition into different grasp patterns. And this provides much more functionality.
So this grasp pattern is a lateral pinch, which is a nice advantage. And then also, what happens when you just relax?
One of the other advantages of this product is that when you relax, it goes into a neutral mode, which has a very natural appearance. And I really like the natural appearance of the Michelangelo hand.
And that's different from some of the old hands that you could be walking down the street and all of a sudden they'd be doing this or something else. And so this is much more aesthetic.
Right, absolutely. After a certain amount of time, the hand will just naturally go back into this pattern.
How is the speed of this hand and the grasping pressure of the hand compared to other hands that you've had in the past?
The speed is pretty much comparable to other hands. It's very quick. It is also very quick transitioning into the different modes. And as far as the grip force, the Michelangelo hand is much stronger than other compliant hands that I've used in the past.
Great, and why is that important?
What's important is because I can perform more daily activities with this hand. I don't have to be as careful with it, and my actions are more spontaneous with the Michelangelo hand as opposed to other products that I've used.
Great. As being one of the first people in the world to try this hand, you had the unique opportunity to go over to Vienna and be involved in the testing of it. Can you tell me a little bit about that experience?
I really enjoyed the opportunity to go to Vienna, particularly because we got to work with everyone that's involved with the production of the Michelangelo hand, from the engineers who designed the original product, to the programmers, to occupational therapists, to the prosthetists. So it was a dynamic, multidisciplinary process where we really got to investigate many of the different functions of the hand, from daily functionality as well as materials, strengths, and just the capabilities of the hand itself.
So Ethan, you've had the opportunity to use lots of different hands. Can you tell me what you think is unique about the Michelangelo hand?
Well, I like the robustness of the Michelangelo hand, and I also like the flexible wrist that is incorporated in the Michelangelo hand. And I also enjoy the fact that it just makes things a lot easier.
One of the unique challenges of working with new technology is really coming up with a protocol and a method to teach our patients how to maximize that new technology and those new functions. At Advanced Arm Dynamics, we utilize our therapeutic approach with our trained occupational therapists in all of our offices to make sure that patients have the very best training to optimize their function.
Explain a little bit how yours is set up.
One of the aspects that makes the Michelangelo hand so versatile is the ability to program it. So for each patient, we can program specific functions of the hand to make it easier based on the level of their amputation and the condition of their muscles. And the other really cool thing that it does is it allows the patient to really see what his muscles are doing and the signals that control the hand and be able to work with that feedback system to optimize control.
Yeah, I think this allows for a much quicker learning process, and it generates a much more responsive interaction between the patient, the prosthetist, and the device.